What's up, everyone? Welcome to Power Play with CJ. Today I was scrolling through Twitter, and J.J. Watt, the star defensive end for the Houston Texans, tweeted out a picture of a custom Ducks, you know, classic Mighty Ducks movie jersey, Watt number 99, which is, you know, pretty awesome if I do say so myself. You know, it's, obviously I'm assuming it's a 2 or 3 XL. He's a big boy, 6'5", about 290, but my thing is, he was, you know, played a little bit of hockey growing up in Wisconsin. Got to ask yourself, what kind of player would he have been if he chose hockey? And I brought this up with Tom Glavine. I brought it up. I've thought about it out loud with NFL linebacker James Laurinaitis, who's a really good high school player in Minnesota. But, I mean, I think Watt, you know, he'd be 6'5", probably 230 in the NHL. Even that's pushing it, but 225, 230 at 6'5". As a defenseman, or I mean, even as a power forward, you know, you're looking at a guy that, you know, really mixes it up physically, amazing athletic ability, and just tenacity, oozes toughness. And, you know, he's a competitor. And, I mean, you look at him getting in there on the forecheck or, you know, slamming someone through the boards with the mindset he has. And, you know, he's got an amazing football IQ. He's great to watch as a, and I'm really looking forward to watching Houston's defense next season with him and Jadeveon Clowney on both ends of the line. But I think Watt would have been a beast at hockey. I really think, again, you're looking at either a 6'5", you know, Chris Pronger type, only heavier, cross between Chris Pronger and Dan O'Chara, or a, you know, power forward that, you know, get going for that, the Al Secor type, you know, that'd be pretty sweet. And, I mean, you know, college football at Wisconsin, I think he would have been a pretty good college hockey player for Coach Eves and the Badgers. I mean, I think, you know, they have an okay track record at producing quality NHL players. I mean, look no further than this year's playoffs. I think Wisconsin alumni are actually leading the NHL in terms of points, goals, and assists by, you know, a college hockey program. You know, looking at Rene Bork, who had a really good run for the Habs. You know, obviously Ryan McDonough's been amazing, and Derek Stepan, both New York Rangers. And, you know, you're just looking at those guys who have been, you know, big parts of their team's success going in the playoffs. And I think had things turned out differently for Mr. Watt, he would, his name would be up there. But, I mean, he made an okay career choice in choosing to play defensive end for the Houston Texans. You know, as a first-round pick, he's, you know, getting paid. And, you know, I think he's going to go down as one of the all-time great pass rushers, and especially next year, on a improved Houston Texans defense. But again, pretty cool to think about what he would look like as a hockey player. I mean, as a, you know, legitimate pro hockey player. You know, if you just take that motor and the physicality and tenacity, put it on skates, something to think about. And I mean, you know, the way he comes off the edge, you know, you can imagine him getting in there, working the boards, you know, working the front of the net. It's would have been a scary thought, and I'm sure players around the NHL are, you know, count their lucky stars that he's chasing quarterbacks and not defensemen on the forecheck. But, you know, anyway, that's all I got in this episode of the Power Play with CJ. And actually, if JJ Watt wants one, we're going to get him a Power Play shirt. Probably have to get it a couple X's, but I can facilitate that because Power Play with CJ. But anyway, that's all I got in this episode of the Power Play. Stay tuned for more episodes throughout the playoffs, the finals, and beyond. Later, guys.